If you're in a hurry and you want to grab a snack on the go, what's the easiest snack available to you? It's a snack bar. Hi, this is me, nutritionist Dhvani Shah. I'm here with yet another episode of the Film's Way of Life, and today I'm going to review some popular snack bars available in the market. Snack bars come in various categories. They can be energy bars, they can be meal replacers, or they can be protein bars. Each of these are meant to suit different needs, and we usually confuse them with each other. So let me review these bars for you today. What I have here with me is a meal replacer bar. I have some energy bars and I have a protein bar. So when these bars are made, there are a few key ingredients that go into them. If it's a protein bar, it's always a protein supplement that will be added to them. If it's an energy bar, the base is usually oats, nuts, some dried fruit or chocolate. What binds them together are some crucial binding agents that make or break the nutrition value of these bars. Not to forget the colors or additives that are added to enhance the taste. So let us see how each of them fare. I'm starting with the very favorite Nature Valley Granola bar, which is in the apple crunch flavor. What you need to see is what's written on the front versus what's written behind. What's written on the front is that it's a 190 kilocalorie bar and it's a 9.5% of the daily nutrition requirement. What I read behind is now that's important. So I read that this bar contains a lot of sunflower lecithin, it contains sodium bicarbonate, it contains molasses, it contains artificial and natural flavoring substances, and it contains some sugar, some rolled oats, some honey, and some emulsifiers. So essentially, this has 50% of the goodness with 50% of the artificial substances added to it to make sure it's healthy. Nutritionally, the pack says that it has about 12.4 grams of sugar, not carbohydrate. That means it's a little over 2 teaspoons of sugar in just this much of a bar. It also says that it has 130 grams of sodium. That's a little more than 1 teaspoon of salt going into your system with just one bar. That goes into an entire meal actually. Coming to the Unibig bar, what the Unibig bar uses as a binding agent is some glucose syrup, it uses some vegetable fat, it uses a soya emulsifier. It uses a humectant, that's actually a substance that causes a lot of breathing problems in children. And it uses some coca solids, it uses some hydrogenated fat, and it uses milk solids. So in fact, all of these, the solids and the hydrogenated fat, are made from oil which has been processed with some gases to give hydrogenated fat. It looks and tastes like butter. It does not melt. It has a very good shelf life, but it clogs your arteries. So I'm sure I'm not going to be eating this bar for some time. Coming to a meal replacer bar. So what this bar says it can do is it can replace your lunch or dinner with just this much. Yes, it is heavy, it is satiating, and I'm sure it's tasty, but what goes into it nutritionally is what I'm here today for. So along with the protein blends, it has some chocolate, it has some rolled oats, it has some fructose as a flavoring, it has gums added, it has soy lecithin, it has sunflower oil, palm kernel oil, and some maltitol. So I would say this bar ranks somewhere in between. Yes, it does have added nutrients, it does have added flavors to it, but it does not have so much of the added synthetic emulsifying agents or humectants to it. That makes it a little more natural on my digestive system. But make sure you eat this with caution. Whenever you eat this or overeat this, you might be prone to diarrhea or you might be prone to a nauseating effect. So whenever you eat this, you need to drink a lot of water or have a lot of high fiber salad with it. Moving on to the yoga bar. So the yoga bar is a protein bar. Whereas this had 30 grams of protein, this has 20 grams of protein. This is ideally recommended when somebody is on a workout or on heavy exercise or playing an intensive sport. So they can have one of these bars after playing it or half an hour before playing the sport. Checking the ingredients here, what I find is it has the protein blends, it has Belgian chocolate, it has a little bit of lecithin added. It has flax seeds, apple fiber, and a little bit of natural added flavor. So what I'm happy to read is it says it has vanilla and rosemary extract. Extracts usually come from the natural fruit or the natural spice, whereas a flavor is made synthetically in a lab. So I find that yoga bar is one of the most natural products of the lot that I have here today. So after knowing what the contents of these bars are, it's time for a reality check. Let's put these to the taste test. I'm going to start with the Unibic fruit and nut chocolate bar. Smells just like a Cadbury Dairy Milk fruit and nut chocolate. Quite easy to break. Believe me, it tastes delicious. If I were to give it to kids, they would love to have it every day. Though this tastes good, it has a bit aftertaste of an artificial flavoring. And that's not something which I would like to eat, nor I would like to recommend. Moving on to the Nature Valley Apple Crunch Bar. This is a proper granola bar. It's meant to be crunchy. The perfect crunch, the well-balanced apple and cinnamon flavor, none of it overpowering. Even though it's artificially flavored, fortunately the flavor is not very chemically. So that was one of the favorite granola bars, but again, I found it a little too sugary for my taste. Moving on to my meal replacer bar. This is supposed to be really heavy duty because it's supposed to give you the energy worth one meal. So yes, it does look really heavy duty. This one is a chocolate almond flavor. It does remind me of a protein shake, and it reminds me of a medicine that I used to have as a kid. So, well I would say it's average on the taste, not too bad. You can definitely eat an entire bar without flinching, but it's not a very pleasant taste. And moving on to the yoga bar. This actually is not as sticky, caramelly, gooey as the other bars. I think because it does not have those kind of emulsifiers added to it. It reminds me of those chocolate barfis that we used to have as kids, but a little less on the sugar content. So, not too bad taste wise. If I were to eat a few more bites, yes, I would find it a little dry on my mouth, but it's a very good bargain in terms of the balance between taste and health. It's commonly believed that health food is not tasty, and to break the myth, a lot of brands resort to adding some substances like flavors, additives, emulsifiers to make sure their food tastes delicious. Well, I would say if you eat a naturally healthy food, you develop your taste buds accordingly, and that is delicious for you. So now for the final verdict. Let us go on to rating these bars on a scale of 1 to 5. So the FIMS Nutrimeter says the Unibig bar stands at 2, Nature Valley stands at 2.5, Max Protein bar stands at 3.5, and the yoga bar stands at 4, because I give natural nutrition more importance than just taste. I hope you found this review useful. Stay on for more such reviews and nutri tips from me, nutritionist Dhvani Shah.